Learn how to make two different nifty circular designs in Adobe Illustrator. We're going to use various different techniques and tips, and you won't believe how easy it actually is. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Today, there are two different circular vector designs made easy. And for the first one, select a color and then make a small sample using the rectangle tool off of the artboard to one side. In the color picker menu, copy the hex color code at the bottom with Command or Control C. We're going to use this soon. But for now, cover the entire artboard with the same color using the rectangle tool, M being the shortcut on your keyboard. And then simply lock it down in place with Command or Control 2. Now, press L for the ellipse tool, and then click and drag whilst holding down Shift to generate a perfect circle. Now choose a gradient fill in the bottom left of your screen, and then click on one side of the gradient, like so. Make sure to choose the RGB mode in the top right corner, so we can then paste in the hex color code with Command or Control V. Now this is just so that this part of the gradient matches and blends into the background perfectly. The other side of the gradient needs to be a kind of light grey color, but of course you can choose whatever colors that you want to use. As you see later, I experimented with blues and purples. Now, we're going to make use of Illustrator's automated actions for the next step in this vector design. So go ahead and open up the Actions panel here. And then click New Action in the top right window. Illustrator is now recording your every single move, but just copy the circle with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplicate with Command or Control F. You can see in the Actions panel, my steps are being listed. But then transform the new shape by reducing its scale by 75% here. Finally, rotate the circle by a certain degrees, like so. Once you've done that, hit stop in the Actions panel. You've now saved that action from start to finish. And all we need to do now is to select the new circle and then click play. Illustrator is going to repeat every single step that we just made over and over again. That's pretty neat. Of course, you can add or use any colors that you wish, but here is the first circular vector design. However, we have the main event coming up. So again, take the ellipse tool and this time click the artboard just once. Create a circle with a set size and then remember that size. Repeat this process by making the new circle a certain amount smaller. So for me, 40 points smaller. Then rotate the circle by a certain amount of degrees. But then do this again for using the same amount of size smaller in scale, but double the rotational values. I've tried to automate this, but Illustrator doesn't remember the decrease in the size of the circle every single time. So we need to do it manually. But yeah, keep doing this until you have a nice amount of circles on your artboard, and they probably are going to be scattered all over the place, which is fine. All you need to do now is open up the Align window, which you can find here, or under Window and Align at the very top. Make sure you do not have the Align to Artboard setting checked, and then align the circles horizontally and vertically. And there you have it, two circular vectors made in under 5 minutes. I personally think they look really neat, but let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. It's fun to experiment with shapes in Illustrator and using different functions to make some designs. Make sure to subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.